GraphQL is a query language for communicating about data. But before we jump in and start building, it's helpful to explore some of the concepts behind the code. To do this, let's look at the evolution of GraphQL architectures and understand how they've led to the birth of the graph.
So let's take it back to 2014, when we were still doing the Ice Bucket Challenge and GraphQL hadn't been released yet. You know the drill. We need to give clients, maybe a web app or a mobile app, the ability to fetch information. With REST APIs, we write a lot of data fetching code to connect our app to each data source we need. But in the case of GraphQL, things work a bit differently. A GraphQL API describes what data it has with a schema, which acts a bit like a menu of all our available data. This allows an app to request the exact data it needs from multiple sources with a GraphQL operation.
This new way to fetch data was a game changer. With GraphQL, we could build apps faster than ever before. We started by building our first schema inside one service, but as more people contributed to the schema, this simple service grew more complex. Although it was convenient having one window into all of our data, our monolith caused a bottleneck. We weren't sure who was in charge of what, we were often breaking things for other teams, and we inevitably ran into scaling issues. And so, we started spinning up separate GraphQL APIs for each client. We were super productive at first, but eventually all those messy point-to-point connections were difficult to maintain. We were duplicating code, and we lost something from our monolith days. The dream of having one central view of all of our data.
How could we scale GraphQL to hundreds of clients while still keeping our dream alive? How could we maintain one view of all of our data while also allowing developers to ship code quickly and independently? The answer was the graph, a way to write our schema code in separate modules, but also to compose them together using federation. The graph is made up of connected but independent subgraphs, giving us one view into all of our data, whilst also giving us the flexibility to change each part.
So the massive adoption of GraphQL has led to the birth of the graph, a new layer of the stack which sits between the client and service layers. The graph brings all of our data, services, and capabilities together into one consistent and discoverable place that anyone can access with a GraphQL query. With the graph, we can build independently and freely, which means we can share our ideas with the world faster than ever before.